these tests will help Miss O'Brien figure out where little girl needs help. Well, I don't know what planet the president is on, but the fact of the matter is, this is baloney. High-stakes test results almost never come back until the end of the year in most states, in Texas, New York, and Massachusetts. By the time the scores come back, they're not your students any longer. They have no role, they have no diagnostic role in helping you to find out where that child's weaknesses may lie. Their only function is to humiliate the school, to embarrass the principal, and to drive the principal further and further in the direction of doing rote and drill instruction next time around so that she can possibly pump the test scores before a second year of failure. Principals, even really good ones, I mean the best ones, are in a state of continual anxiety. And they pass it down to the teachers, and or typically you can't even say used, utilized. You know, the standards people want you to use big words. You know, it's a common affliction of poorly educated bureaucrats. To be honest, they think big words sort of substitute for real sophistication. You know, so you can't say we copied an idea, replicate. You know, it's all that phony education jargon.
Children will prove themselves proficient, that's it, at the production of a narrative procedure. So I said, well, I went to a pretty good college, majored in English. I don't know what the hell that means. So the teacher says it means they'll write a story. So I said, a narrative. So I said, well, why don't you just write that on the board? He said, you can't. When the curriculum cops come around, the accountability people, they want to see their words and their number. The number, my friends, is useless. It's worthless. It has no benefit to children. This is a pure case of sacrificing the interests of children to the accountant mentality that's been foisted on our schools by the president's bill, by NCLB. The number is useless. I have the highest possible expectations of inner city children. All good teachers do. We don't need to be lectured on that by dumbo politicians who, you know, say, if your children aren't scoring well, it must be that you have low expectations, as though we were a bunch of, as though we came to this career because we thought, oh, I'd love to teach in a place where I can expect the least of my students. So we had sort of demented psyches. Teachers, and I'm talking about the best teachers, these wonderful young idealists that I keep recruiting, they hate it. They hate these drill and kill curricula because they were educated. The wonderful young teachers that I'm recruiting were educated in the best schools. They're the ones who went to the top suburban systems. They know what real education is. They were taught to question. They were taught to read not just out of pit-pat readers, phonics readers, but they learned phonics out of good literature as well at the same time. They learned not just, that you have to sound out the words, but that the purpose of doing this is ultimately to take pleasure in something beautiful. And they see schools that are stripped of all of that, and it makes them sick, and they hate it, and they quit.